This is Afternoon Sports Slay with the Queen, Micah K. Now remember, I'm doing this for the love of the game. If you are new to my channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button. Definitely hit that like button and definitely hit that notification bell. Make sure you are commenting, telling the Queen how you feel. Make sure you are sharing this content. Make sure you are tapping in and spreading the word to other sports fans and boxing fans. Let's get into it, all right? A lot of good boxing coming up this Saturday night. We have Virgil Ortiz versus Kevin Velasquez. All right, now when I say Kevin Velasquez's name, I am going to use his nickname, Mean Machine. Let's get into it. If you're new to my channel, this is how I do it. I give out the background information first, then I give you my analysis, and then I give you the prediction. All right, background information. The source is from The Zone by Stephen M. Let's get into it. Virgil Ortiz faces a significant test against Mean Machine this Saturday night live on The Zone. All right, now boxing welterweight divisions, arguably the sport's deepest weight category. All right, let me make sure I said that properly. Boxing's welterweight division is arguably, the sport's deepest weight category, with a number of high profile fighters such as Errol Spence, Terrence Crawford, and Manny Pacquiao occupying the top spots. The race to join them is intensifying. All right, ladies and gentlemen, even though, you know, side note, you know, being a little sad right now, Spence and Pacquiao, the fight is not happening. All right, my goodness, but I'm still gonna be tapped in because we have Pac-Man versus Ugas now. Okay, but it is getting a little disappointing at times, but if you're a true boxing fan, you know, you got to keep hope alive. Now let's continue. One fighter desperate to join them is Virgil Ortiz Jr. The Texan fighter is one of Americans boxing brightest hopes, and he can make a claim to the leading places as he takes on, all right, former Crawford victim Mean Machine on Saturday night. All right, excuse me guys, I was looking at the notes like, what was that on the paper? Now let's get into the analysis part with Ortiz. The last two fights was Maurice Hooker and Samuel Vargas. He won both fights with knockouts in the seventh round. Once again, we're doing Ortiz analysis first. All right, now let's get into the thick of things. Let's get into the juice with the Ortiz analysis. He is a very high volume active fighter, uses a lot of combos from different directions, definitely has power, of course. He's undefeated with 17 knockouts. All right, he applies pressure at all times, nice body work with the left and the right. All right, shows a variety of punches, left hooks, right hooks, using double jab usage as well. Now you name the punch, Virgil will unleash it, especially in the heat of the battle. All right, to me, overall, he is just a very tough and relentless fighter. All my slayers and slayers, how do you feel about it? Now let's get into what I'm looking for from Virgil Ortiz. He has to make sure that he stays patient. He has to make sure he keeps composure. I would like to see, you know, at times still more head movement, and make sure he just stays in control. Now let's transition over to the Mean Machine, and let me give you my analysis for him. His last two fights, if I'm saying that properly, was against Michael Z and Terrence Crawford. Now Mean Machine won by technical knockout in the eighth round against Michael, all right, or Michael, and he lost to Crawford by TKO in the ninth. Now I forgot how to say Michael. All right, now let's transition over to the analysis part. Let's get into the juice with the Mean Machine. Now the Mean Machine, for those, you know, for those who might not know, but of course, if you're a true boxing fan, you know, he has punching power in both hands. He likes to land the right hand over the top of the jab. Now, Mean Machine has a 81% knockout power rate, all right? He definitely has some quickness, nice left and right uppercut, especially it can be well placed, all right? Nice jab usage. He applies pressure, has good body work with good accuracy. Overall, very good fighter with a dangerous right hand, okay? Now, what I'm looking for from Mean Machine, make sure his conditioning is good. Make sure to throw enough combos. Has a, you know, to me, okay, let me think about it for a second. He definitely has kind of like a wide stance for sure. Now, he needs to make sure he makes the necessary adjustments, has to land effective, good punches, definitely has to stay very active against Virgil, needs to control the pace. Now, also, the Mean Machine is a very aggressive fighter, definitely to me, because when I'm thinking back on his fights, he's very aggressive, but he has to consistently stay aggressive, especially going up against somebody like an Ortiz, all right? Also, I would like to see more foot movement with him at times as well. Now, let's transition over to my prediction. Right now, as of right now, I definitely have Virgil Ortiz winning this fight. I'm not doing, you know, predicting a knockout or any round or nothing like that, but I definitely have Ortiz winning. Now, that's not to take anything away from Mean Machine, because Ortiz definitely has to be careful with the Mean Machine, because the Mean Machine definitely has that power. He got, you know, a little pop. So, we'll see what's going to happen. Now, remember, I'm doing this for the love of the game. If you are new to my channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button. Make sure you hit the like and definitely hit the notification bell. It's the Queen Micah K, and this is Afternoon Sports Slay. You know it's more on the way. Don't go nowhere.